Welcome back. Now we proceed to the next urogenital malignancy, that is carcinoma of penis. Then certain communities are considered to be immune from this disease. But if we know why it is happening, then it is easy that it is not just a community based, but it is basically a religion based. So Jews and Muslims are actually immune from this particular entity of CA penis, because the neonates are circumcised immediately after birth. There are certain precancerous lesions which will definitely land up and form the CA penis, such as Bowen's leukoplakia, erythroplasia, that is Paget's disease of the penis, giant condyloma, human papilloma virus infection, and verrucous carcinoma. Now all these are typically precancerous lesions. One need to differentiate it very, very carefully. These are not predisposing factors, but these all have malignant potential and they will form a malignancy. Clinically, what one can see? Now here I have drawn a simple diagram which will give you an overview of various stages of CA penis. Initially, a patient can present to us with nothing but a simple white patch on the glans penis. We call it as leukoplakia of the glans. Few patients do present to us with a red velvety patch on the glans penis. We call it as erythroplakia. Then sometimes there can be simple ulceration without any color differentiation. Sometimes the patient can have ulceration at the corona glandis, and sometimes there is obvious solid tumor located in the shaft of the penis. So this solid tumor can be of cauliflower in nature. So clinically, what the patient will inform to us, that patient will complain of passage of blood in the urine, usually terminally, because the terminal urethra is getting involved. Initially, the flow of urine will be clear, but as the end, this small tumor will open up and will pass the blood. So it is a late symptom actually, which shows the infiltration and involvement of the penile urethra, which is actually a bad prognostic indicator. Sometimes these patients present to us with palpable swelling in the groin region, or they will just complain that there is something in my groin. So if you examine it, you will understand there are enlarged inguinal lymph nodes, which again is a hallmark of advanced disease and carries a bad prognosis. Investigations. We have to do certain basic routine investigations for general body checkup of the patient, for fitness for offering various type of modalities of treatment. That is complete blood count or complete hemogram. Urine routine microscopy, very, very important to rule out any subsequent infection. Ulcer swab is taken from the ulcer area. That is a biochemical swab for culture sensitivity to rule out concomitant infection in the particular ulcer bed. Sometimes we need to take ulcer biopsy from the edge to ascertain what type of malignancy this particular patient is suffering from. FNSE is advocated and done from the involved ipsilateral lymph node region. To stage the disease, we need to have a CT scan of abdomen and pelvis. It will delineate the stage of the tumor spread in the retroperitoneum, which is very, very vital for offering treatment to our patient. And as we have already seen, there is again a role of sentinel lymph node. One needs to understand, as the disease will engulf or infiltrate the skin around the penis, the lymph node will be evident. If the skin is not involved, there will not be any lymph node that is evident on the inguinal region. Again, it shows little advanced disease. So to stage, we use a TNM staging, that is tumor node metastasis. T1, no lamina propria involvement. T2, corpora cavernosa involvement. T3, urethral involvement. And T4, surrounding organ involvement. But this is a little outdated classification. But for theory purpose, I have mentioned it. What we use for practical usefulness is modified Jackson's staging system, which classifies or stages the disease into four main categories. First, carcinoma in the glans penis. Second, carcinoma in the shaft of the penis involving either of the corpora. Third, operable lesion with mobile but hard inguinal nodes. And fourth, surrounding inoperable lymph node with other distant metastasis of the disease. Treatment. Now, treatment is basically surgery. Circumcision, when done in the neonatal age group, is definitely going to confer immunity to the patient. Now, why? We have to understand. In certain races or certain communities, circumcision is not done at all. For example, Hindu religion. Now, in this, what goes wrong? There is collection of smegma or secretions coming from the various glands beneath the corona. So these glands will secrete substances which are necessary for lubrication and which actually prevents the phimosis. But if the daily hygiene is not maintained, then they form adhesions in between the glans penis and the preputial skin. And this smegma is considered to be carcinogenic in nature. That is why these patients who are not circumcised and especially not maintaining a very good penile hygiene are prone for subsequent development of CA penis. So if circumcision done, at least they will maintain good hygiene. That is what is anticipated. Now, when the lesion is limited till the coronal level or in the very distalmost part of the penis, one can offer partial penile amputation. Now, here what we can do, we remove the portion with at least 2.5 cm clear margin of having a shaft. If you can at least achieve a 2.5 cm to 3 cm of the penile shaft, it is considered as a partial penile amputation. If the tumor is further proximal, then we cannot salvage the penis and we have to offer patient a complete amputation of the penis or complete excision. So if the partial amputation is done, what is good for the patient? Patient can still void urine terminally as he is voiding otherwise, that is from the terminal distal opening. But if the patient undergoes a complete amputation, then one needs to reconfigure the urethra, because patient cannot just void urine from a small opening. We have to relocate the urethral opening to perineum. On what we do is a perineal urethrostomy when total amputation is attempted. In a situation when patient is also having inguinal lymph node disease, then it is very, very important for one to offer block dissection of the ipsilateral involved inguinal region. But before block dissection, what is important? Many times what we have observed is infection also supervenes in this scenario. So what we offer is good course of antibiotics for at least 21 days, that is 3 weeks. So if we give a 3 weeks antibiotic course and still the lymph nodes fail to subside, it means practically that there is tumor infiltration and this particular patient warrants a block dissection in the inguinal region. The newer modalities of treatment in the CA penis is use of laser, that is CO2 laser for surface ablation of the earlier tumor. Leukoplakia, erythroplakia can be cured with the use of lasers. Sometimes NDYG, that is neodymium yttrium aluminium carbonate based laser, is used for the deep seated lesions at the corona and can confer good results without actually attempting any surgery. Radiation therapy. Now here, interestingly, this radiation is a brachytherapy. We have already discussed this issue. I will again refocus this issue that radiation therapy can be either a brachytherapy when in close proximity or a teletherapy from a distance. So here we give a brachytherapy. We have a special apparatus that fits over the glans penis and through which a cross proximity radiation is given. Sometimes local iridium needles needs to be implanted in the penile shaft to advocate the radiation. Local chemotherapy can be given in this scenario. We can use 5-FU, that is 5-fluorouracil paste, as a cream application over the affected ulcer zone, and one can actually cure the residual disease. Few surgeons or few urologists have advocated use of cryosurgery, but there is no definite benefit or no proven benefit, so we do not recommend it. What we do is Mohs micro dissection. This is basically for salvaging the penile stump and also for inguinal block dissection. It's very important that you meticulously remove entire tumor from the region and try to achieve R0 resection. Now, what is R0 resection? R2 means one, we leave behind something that is gross malignancies left behind, that called as R2 resection. R1 resection means we know that to naked eye there is no malignancy, but on the histopathology the margins are involved, that is R1 resection. And R0 means microscopically or macroscopically no residual tumor is in the region where we have operated. Lastly, sometimes few patients can be benefited with systemic chemotherapy with bleomycin or methotrexate. So as to summarize, this CA penis will have important implication. The simplest modality of offering circumcision to the neonate can actually virtually make the patient immune from suffering from this malignancy. However, certain STDs, that is sexually transmitted diseases, needs to be prevented because there is a chance of small ulcerations and this organism getting lodged into the glans penis or at the corona and subsequently producing the CA penis.